Good afternoon, one and all present over here.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
I am Jagadeeswari, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE. I'm going to handle a small session under the topic Warshall's algorithm. So Warshall's algorithm finds application in so many computer networks. First, it is used to identify whether a node is having reachability from all the other nodes. So this is the first application of Warshall's algorithm. Suppose in computer networks, if so many systems have been interconnected, whether a particular system is reachable or not, whether there exists a path to reach that particular node is available or not, we are able to obtain this information with the help of Warshall's algorithm. Okay, now let us see a small example network, and we are applying Warshall's algorithm to find the reachability of the computer network. So the main application of Warshall algorithm is to identify the reachability of a node existing in a computer network. Okay, we are also having an advanced version of Warshall's algorithm or modified Warshall's algorithm, which is used to identify the shortest path between every vertex to every other vertices. Okay, this is simple Warshall algorithm. Now let us take a simple network which consists of only three nodes. So this is a network which consists of three nodes. This is a directed network because the connections are having the directions. Okay, this is a directed and connected network. For this, we have to construct the reachability matrix R of 0. Okay, in Warshall algorithm, we have to construct, at each and every stage, we have to construct R of 0, R of 1, R of 2 and so on, etc. up to R of K we have to construct. Here R of 0 represents the reachability matrix with the 0 intermediate node, and R of 1 represents the reachability matrix with the only one intermediate node. Up to this we have to construct R of K, that is the maximum number of available nodes is represented with the help of K. Up to that we have to construct the reachability matrix. So the initial reachability matrix R of 0 can be constructed like this. So we have three nodes in the networks A, B, C, and we have to construct 3x3 matrix. Three nodes, three columns matrix we have to construct, and if there is any self loop available in the network, we have to ignore the self loop. Self loop in the sense, the edge that is interconnecting a node to itself is a self loop. That is, if there is an edge connects from A to A, this is a self loop. If a node connect, if an edge connecting B to B, this is a self loop. If any self loop is existing, we have to ignore the self loops and we have to take the some other edges only. And self loops we have to ignore, A to A, B to B and C to C we have to ignore. And we have to check whether an edge, direct edge existing from A to B. Yes, there is an edge existing between A to B. So we have to mention here as 1. That is, an edge is connecting from A to B. And A to C also, there is any edge connecting, there is no edge connecting. So we have to represent it as 0. Here 0 represents there is no edge available. 1 represents there is an edge available. And B to A, there is no edge connecting. Only we are having A to B edges connecting, but not B to A. So here we will represent as 0. And next, B to C we will have 1 because there is an edge interconnects directly from B to C. So we have to represent as 1. Next, we have to take the node, third node C, and there is no connection from C to A and C to B. We have connections from B to C alone, not C to B. And there is no edge connecting from C to A also. So we have to represent this as 0 and 0. So this is the initial matrix which is represented as R of 0.